took a trip down Amnesia Lane to see how much Birkenhead had changed. Saw backheads with headbags back full of deceased. Saw hard knocks with hard dogs patrolling the street. I witnessed things that made me stop and think, and things that made me turn to drink. I guess I was looking for the missing link, but the town with a frown remained the same. Everybody seems to wear counterfeit clothes that have been bought by those with counterfeit notes they've just had rolled up the nose. Freedom of expression seems to be lost if all you ever wear is the badge of Lacoste. In the world of the scally, there's no finer designer, although I've seen more originality in communist China. Follow the leader, follow the crowd, where a mind of your own is not allowed. Things had changed, I had aged, even the Samaritans were permanently engaged. The beer-bellied bully boys had put down roots and hung up their boots to be replaced by tracksuits, tracksuits. Even the lap dancing club had closed, after less than a year in town. Probably because the girls refused to take their tracky bottoms down. It's Birkenhead Revisited. If you want real life, well this is it. The visible panty line of life. Less top model, more reader's wife. Struggling to walk in 3-inch heels after one too many chippy meals. It's the bargain basement babes and the tanned unmanned one night stands. Girls who love to misbehave with their orange coloured mammary glands. Unsupervised at the makeup box, they turn and gurn in ecstasy. Microscopic miniskirts strain in vain against the weight that is expectancy. And the girl from the Cavendish with the vodka and lime murders I Will Survive for the 1,000th time. Sometimes I'm not that arsed, but tonight it really got to me. It was like THE Gloria Gaynor, but with a tracheotomy. All men's twisted faces reveal the telltale traces of one too many happy hours in the most desperate of places. Thinking how things could have been if ambitions weren't ignored. The dreams they failed to act upon and the goals they could have scored. Pockmarked pickets pick their own pockets for poultry paint packets to keep the kids in shoes. While complete and utter nutters who've been dragged from the gutters are banging on the shutters in a desperate search for clues. Birkenhead. Something. Things more severe than beer. Even the ventriloquist dummy says, have you got any gear? Have you got any gear? There's acid heads with massive heads, potheads with passive heads. The speed freaks speak for weeks to the crackheads and the smackheads. Wannabe gangsters with pained expressions talk out the side of their mouths with feigned discretion, giving it all the spiel about keeping it real and how to make the big impression. Verbal shrapnel pierces the air as an ice cream van sound system blasts from an open car window with the mistaken belief that for some unknown reason I might appreciate listening to the same appalling shite as they do. Thanks, but no thanks. And the godlike figure of Danny Giles sits at the end of the bar and smiles. Says it's the greatest place in the British Isles. Then falls off his stool and bangs his head. Another night in paradise, or just another night in Birkenhead? Oh yes.
disease. It's probably got Danny Giles in.